When you're using the Cura slicer with an Ender 3 profile, there's these lines that show up within the slicer that prevent you from printing on the full-size bed. Well, there's a way to get rid of those lines, and I'll show you how to do it right here at Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you every week by these Patreon supporters. I'll show you here on version 4.5 of Cura. You can see these gray areas. They're like a keep out area where the clips would be to hold the bed in place, but the clips aren't across the whole thing. And if I slide a CHEP cube into that gray area, it turns camouflage. Pull it out, it goes back solid, put it in, goes camouflage. If I try to slice it while it's in there, it says unable to slice. And it gives me a message that I'm in this area that's, you know, not printable. Well, we know it is printable. So if I pull it out, goes solid, slices just fine. So we need to get rid of that area because we can go around the clips. We know how to handle that. And what bothers me more is if I just extend this thing in the Y direction to 200, look at this, it's hitting. I'm not even getting the 220 by 220 between the clips. So these lines have to go. Now I looked at 3.6, which I use a lot, and there's no keep out area. So this is definitely something that was added with version 4.something, and it's really kind of a pain. Well, 4.6.1 did something a little different to address this. They didn't get rid of it, but the Ender 3 still has those areas and they're not quite as big, but they also offer now an Ender 3 Pro profile, which doesn't have clips. So you don't see that keep out area. It's got a magnetic bed. So if you want it, just switch to the Ender 3 Pro profile. You don't have it. If you want them back in there, switch to Ender 3. That's one way to handle it. But what if you want to stay with an older version, say a 4.2 or 4.3 or even 4.5? Is there a way to fix it? Yes, there is. This is how you can fix it. On a Mac, if you right-click, Show Package Contents, Contents, Resources, Resources, Definitions, you'll find a file, Ender 3 definition file. On a Windows machine, that's under whatever version you're using, and then Resources, Definitions, and then there's the file. So we're going to edit either of these with a text editor. Open it up in a text editor and find this disallowed areas section. And you can see there's all kinds of dimensions in here. We're going to get rid of those. So between the brackets, I'm going to highlight all that and then just cut it out of this file. Once it's cut, then I'm going to save this file, and then we're going to restart Cura. So I did this to version 4.5 and started it up, and now you can see that area is gone. No more gray lines to interfere, no more blocking me from using the whole bed. So it took all that away. There's still that ring around the outside, but now if I make a print 200, it fits. In fact, if I make a print 220 in the Y direction, it fits. In fact, I can do something 220 by 220 and it fits. So I'm getting the full advertised 220 by 220 build area. So that fixes it. Hopefully that helps you print bigger on your Ender 3 if you're using an older slicer like 4.5 or earlier. But the 4.6, I guess their answer was to just have the Pro version and the regular version, which you can change the regular version same way I showed, but you can have both. And as far as getting bigger, you can make the bed bigger within the profile, go bigger than 235 by 235, but then your print may not be centered anymore when it's centered in the slicer. So you have to play with that as well. There's no perfect solution, but this at least gets rid of those stupid lines that we're protecting for the clips. If you like this, maybe check out some of the other videos that are popping up, and then please click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. That way you don't miss an episode. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.